For a moment, think about the things you do when you wake up in the morning. You open your eyes, breathe, straighten up, stand up and walk, eat and put on your clothes. You talk to your loved ones. Then you go out or look outside through the window and see the deep blue sky. You might even hear the singing of birds outside the window. You feel the warmth of the sun and the wind on your face. There are people in the street, walking or trying to go somewhere in their cars. In short, another ordinary day has begun for you. What you see and hear are all ordinary things, so you don't feel it necessary to think consciously about them. Now, assume that you have lived in one room since you were born. This room is completely bare, without even a small window through which you could see outside. It is furnished with only a few pieces of plain furniture for your basic needs. Suppose that in this room where you lead your life, you are provided with just a few kinds of food and drink necessary for you to survive. Then imagine you are taken out of this room where you have lived all your life and you see the outside world for the first time. In such a situation, what would you think of the world? The broadness of the vista reaching your eyes, the existence of light, the warmth of the sun striking your face, the deep blue color of the sky and the pure white clouds. All of this will certainly dazzle you. Twinkling stars appearing in the sky at night, mountains reaching to the sky in all their magnificence, rivers beautiful to all humanity, lakes and seas, the heavy rain which brings life to the earth, green trees, colorful lilacs and roses, watermelons, strawberries and peaches with their different flavors, cats, dogs and rabbits that inspire affection in human beings, butterflies with their amazing colors, birds and sea creatures. Every new thing you see and every piece of information you learn arouses new excitement in you. You try to learn the reason and origin of everything. As you learn these detailed pieces of information one by one, your mind will pose the same questions repeatedly. How have all these magnificent living things come into existence? How have I myself come into being, since everything has a purpose? Then why am I here? There is no doubt that there can be only one answer to all these questions. These are all examples of God's flawless creative artistry. The presence of God pervades all places, and everyone capable of using their reason will immediately see this immaculate splendor in creation. The most important duty of someone who begins to comprehend the superior might of God and His boundless artistry is to turn to the true Lord of these beauties and to lead a life that will be pleasing to Him. In this film, you will be seeing a few examples from the lives of the magnificent creatures in which God displays His artistry. You will witness how every living thing is created with features appropriate to its surroundings, and how each being that was created required careful planning, calculation, and intelligence. To put it another way, you will see the signs of creation which God reveals to us in these creatures. Indeed, God reveals one of these examples of creation in a verse from the Quran. And in your creation, and all the creatures He has spread about, there are signs for people with certainty. These birds, one of the signs of God's matchless creation with their stunning colors and beautiful appearance, live in colonies in lakes with large quantities of mud. The depth of the water in the lake is important not only for them to feed, but also for them to nest. The different colored feathers vary according to the species of flamingo. The tones may range from pale pink to crimson or vermilion. The food they eat, which is high in alpha and beta carotene, determines the color of their plumage. They feed on diatoms, seeds, blue-green algae, and shelled creatures by filtering them from the water. There are special finger-like projections in the flamingo's beak, which it uses to filter the food particles. Flamingos live in pairs in colonies. Every pair does not breed every year, and there is no specific season for breeding, although the rainy season is more conducive to mating. This is because nest building may be easier in times of rain. It is also easier to find food during such periods. Flamingo nests resemble volcanoes in shape. There are numerous fine details in the nest construction. When building their nests, they use mud, small stones, and their own shed feathers. The most important and noteworthy point here is that the mixture employed by the bird can dry out very quickly. The nest is around 11 inches high. The height of the nest protects the eggs when the water level rises. It takes at least 6 weeks for a pair of flamingos to build a nest. The mother and father take turns to incubate the eggs over a period of between 26 and 31 days. They manage this with ease, despite their long legs. Every pair in the colony mates at the same time, for which reason the majority of these birds lay their eggs and raise their young at the same time. The chicks that hatch out of the eggs are gray in color. That gray will turn to pink over the next 3 years. In this huge colony, the parent birds recognize their own chick by the sound it makes. Each family looks after its own offspring. The young leave the nest when they are 4 to 7 days old. Once all the young in the colony have left the nests, the adults rearrange the nest area where they rear the young flamingos. Flamingos are excellent swimmers. Their webbed feet makes it easier for them to swim. Thanks to the broad, flat structure of their feet, flamingos are able to walk on the mud without sinking. The webs between their toes provide a large surface with which the flamingos can push against the water. All the details in flamingos show that these birds have been created in the most appropriate manner for their environment. This superior creator is Almighty God, Lord of the earth and the heavens and all that lies between.